time coming. It's been a long time coming.
We've been wanting you here for... Yes, we have been wanting you here for a long time.
What happened was our guest didn't show up, and then Jamie was just walking on the street. Sure.
Guardians of the Galaxy.
Yes.
Guardians of the Galaxy is the second biggest moneymaker in the entire world this year. It's humongous. Smash hit. The funny thing is before the movie came out, almost nobody heard of these characters. What people don't understand is that the Guardians of the Galaxy that everyone loves so much is not the original team. The original team is a completely different group of characters.
Who knew that sitting at the table?
Well,
raise your hand.
I knew that. Did you know that?
I certainly knew that.
I did, and it was a large part of, as a child, I did not like space comic books. I was not a fan of the team.
Well, are you a fan of space movies like Star Wars, etc.?
Oh, absolutely, yeah. But there was something about comic books that...
That went beyond the streets, when you got like Gotham City or you got Daredevil, yeah. You got whoever who's like fighting crime, like, oh, I'm going to punch this landlord who's mean in the face. And yeah, this is in
it
space.
It just seems so overdramatic and the characters were just unrelatable, like... I mean, look at this guy right here.
No.
Starhawk,
come on.
Look, there's no bag. This is the first issue of the regular series of Guardians. It's actually Marvel Presents number 3, but this is it. It's only worth $2, fine. We've got a character who was engineered to live on Jupiter, which has no surface. Charlie 27. We've got Martinex, who's evolved to live on Pluto. We've got Yondu, who's the survivor of Earth's only interstellar colony.
And the only guy to show up in some form in the movie.
In the movie, that's true. We have Vance Astro, who's actually the first astronaut to travel to another galaxy. Unfortunately, by the time he got to the other galaxy, they'd already figured out how to get there a lot quicker, so his trip was a complete waste of time.
You know why? Because Vance Astro is a loser.
This is kind of confusing. The new Guardians of the Galaxy exist in the modern day. The old Guardians of the Galaxy exist 1,000 years from now.
Sam, you already lost me.
Well, we're dealing with sort of like, if you are well aware, which I know you all are, with the Legion of Superheroes in DC, it's a similar idea.
Yes.
Enough said.
Guardians of the Galaxy, the original team, takes place, ironically, in the year 3014. Isn't that funny? They are a team of superheroes who are fighting against the Brotherhood of the Badoon, who are a bunch of lizard men who have taken over control of the Earth, okay? So they introduced a new team, but these characters were all pre-existing. Rocket Raccoon is from the 70s. Yeah. Groot is from the 50s.
Gamora, Drax.
But they put them together as a team.
Drax actually was the 80s,
yeah,
right?
Who exists in the present day, but they're also called the Guardians of the Galaxy. But it's a completely different team.
So you're explaining how we got to this new Guardians of the Galaxy.
Yeah.
But when we're talking about this book,
yes,
and why the Guardians of the Galaxy were upon their conception.
Yes.
Which is everything that... As far as, like, art goes, the drawings of these books, the way that they told these stories is everything that was wrong with comics at that point. They were terribly colored. Like,
the art
these
is
guys,
terrible.
These men and women right. that produced these books were so, I want to say, talented.
Stoned?
In the way.
Oh, no.
No, but they were talented in the way that they had to do with it. It's like, well, there's a big, giant pile of feces. We need to shovel it into that area.
Okay,
and
so
they did it. They did. They shoveled it.
I think that the new Guardians of the Galaxy is another case of the right writers taking, like, with the JLI, with what Geoff Johns did with the Suicide Squad, with the Rogues Gallery, of realizing that there are bit players that have a cool factor that when you're going to build a new team, don't make up new guys that are stupid looking. Like,
but these guys,
nobody wants Charlie 27.
Well,
somebody likes Booster Gold.
Yeah, you know,
nobody knows who Charlie 27
George
is.
George likes Booster Gold.
So do I. He's my favorite superhero. That's why I brought him up.
I'm sorry.
But what I'm saying, like you build all these teams of characters with the Suicide Squad, with the West Coast Avengers.
Outsiders.
Like, they're all, yeah, the outsiders, the bit players. Guardians is one of those things. I mean, I bought Rocket Raccoon's cartoons in the 80s when I was in high school, and it was like one of those things where I was like, you know what? It was a fun series. Never thought I'd ever see him again. Like three months later, the movie comes out, and it's like, Rocket Raccoon's in the team? Come on! And it's like, you know what? Build teams out of misfits and guys and girls that have...
When I was a little kid, I came across these characters.
Was that in the 70s, too?
It was in the 80s, and I love them. I'm like, this is so cool. We got a guy from Jupiter. We got a guy from Pluto. The concepts in here are actually amazing.
What about the guy from Uranus?
We have a guy who's the last survivor of the 1980s. He lives inside a suit that keeps him preserved for 1,000 years.
Is that John Travolta?
No.
I thought it was the boy in the bubble. Don't worry about it. He was Italian.
His name's Vance Astro. If his skin gets exposed to the air, he instantly ages 1,000 years. Is that not cool? Well, guess what? This comic is written by Steve Gerber, who's one of the best writers of the 70s. It's drawn by Al Milgram, one of the worst artists of the 70s. Okay, the art's crap. I'll give you that.
It's terrible.
But in this issue, they deal with fascism. They deal with space exploration.
Yeah, but
in
come
this
on.
Issue,
the wives didn't know that their husbands were off for wait, the last 100
okay,
years.
Okay, that's another story.
Occupying
guys,
a,
in
a
this
plane.
Issue,
they had no clue.
Two different characters contemplate suicide. This is a serious issue. This is a serious yeah. story. It's a good series. If you get a chance, pick up Tomorrow's Avengers, Guardians of the Galaxy number 1. This is a good series. The original team. It's good stuff. The art's terrible. George, talk about the art.
The art. The artwork in these books was people like myself and anyone else who could put pen to paper and create characters and get their ideas out there. And I love drawing, and I've met so many people like who do love to create. This was such garbage art that it inspired you to be like, I can do better than this.
Yeah,
these guys are terrible.
I can have
but
a job stores, drawing from Marvel.
No, but yeah, exactly. I can have a job drawing from Marvel because these guys were terrible. But at the same time, I will totally go back to this source material. What great is it? Like, I'm not saying Jack Kirby or anything like that, but there is some great where you had to put a priestess and an alien monkey and somebody else and a guy who can't get out of a suit because he'll age. You have to draw that stuff. It's hard to draw.
But in all honesty, if you're Vance Astro and you know that if you come out of that suit, you age 1,000 years, like, if you're him, you want to do it because you just want to die. It's like,
but here,
you know what? I don't even want to live anymore. I'm Vance Astro. Like,
they deal with
coming out of the suit. Like, you know what I mean?
The art is not great. The writing is awesome. These characters are great. And when the movie came out, when they announced Guardians of the Galaxy, I was like, oh my God, Vance Astro is going to be in a movie? They didn't even do the right
thing.
Thank
God.
They didn't even do the right
thing. That might be the problem, though, is that when you have these misfit teams put together, this team didn't have the backstories of years of, like, oh, you know, having your misfit hero that you love. I didn't know any of these guys. It was just like too much at one time. It was like,
but you know what?
I don't
I
know
think
them.
The word you're looking
I don't
for
know
is
them.
Terrible.
Yes.
The audience of the movie that made $1 billion did not know those characters either, but it was still successful.
Thank God.
Anyways. No, but it was.
Fair enough.
I'll give you that.
George, we have to go to break.
I know.
They're
I
going
was,
to cancel the show.
Oh, right.
Let him say this thing.
No. Right. I want to go to break. That's all what I was saying. Before my pants come off, let's wrap this up.
Okay, we're going to go to break, and then we'll talk about the movie, the Guardians of the Galaxy movie.
All right, there we go.
We're going to talk about